To take an ultra quote from YouTube tech god Marques Brownlee, cheap microphones are getting good, and good microphones are getting cheap, with the CMTech USB and Neewer mics being proof of this. So hopefully, following in that trend, will be the Zach Sound condenser microphone. Wait, the SF66, no, the Sunhua? The Link, the IUKS? Okay, long story short, this microphone has been rebranded beyond belief, but at their core, all these products are the same. And whatever you want to call them, the question remains, are they actually better and cheaper? As usual, this whole review is being recorded on the microphone in question, so keep that in mind as we jump into things, and feel free to start forming an opinion of the audio quality yourself before I share my personal thoughts. To begin, I'm once again pleasantly surprised at the overall build quality of budget devices. This mic is sufficiently solid, with a sturdy soft-touch plastic body, a metal grille on top shielding the capsule inside, and a quarter inch thick piece of foam on the inside, intended to, but not being great at, stopping plosive sounds. The mic's oval shape, which squares off about a third of the way up, really kills this microphone's physical compatibility with a lot of clamps, stands, and shock mounts, and it's easily my biggest complaint about the device as a whole. My second biggest gripe with this mic, though it varies wildly depending on rebranding, is the text on the body, which is just ugly and unfortunately is on the audio pickup side. I will give this microphone points for having a decently thick red rubber 3.5mm microphone cable, the color of which is nice to see, but it immediately loses these points with the clashing orange accents on the rest of the microphone. If they had just picked one color, I would have fully praised its looks, but as it is now, it feels confusing and clashes. As mentioned earlier, this whole review is being recorded on the microphone in question, and I think it sounds passable, but even when compared to the similarly priced CMTech microphone, the latter sounds much more natural to what my voice is actually like. The SF666 Pro has a surprisingly harsh and almost compressed feeling to the sound quality that I did not enjoy, and the overall sound just isn't very pleasant. To hear for yourself, here's a comparison between this mic, my usual microphone, a MacBook Pro mic, and the CMTech USB mic. Oaks grow slowly. Father was calm as he threw the bomb on the dock. An awed audience applauded Claude. An extended comparison is linked in the card right now, as well as in the description down below. So far in this review, I have intentionally talked about nothing but the microphone itself, and that's for good reason. Depending on who you order this microphone from, you will get wildly different accessories in the box, so from here on out, the items I discussed may or may not come with your unit. My unit came with a cheap tripod that is entirely plastic, but surprisingly rigid. It can fold up and allows for rotation of the microphone in all three axes. Overall, it's entirely functional, but takes up more space on my desk than I would have liked. Also in my box was an adapter to convert the 3.5mm microphone jack to USB, so it can technically qualify as a USB microphone. It also has a headphone jack, for added convenience I guess, but it does not allow for hardware monitoring. In every way, it's very cheap, and has the jacks placed together in such a way that I had a difficult time plugging headphones with larger jacks in if the microphone was already connected. And when I connected my headphones to it, compared to my computer's headphone jack, there was literally no bass from the adapter. I suspect this could be going the other way too, and negatively affecting the microphone quality, however I unfortunately couldn't test this to be sure. If you find this microphone without the accessories, then I would save yourself the $10 and instead buy a better arm that will work with future mic upgrades. Spend as much as you feel comfortable on a quality adapter, or just use your computer's built-in sound card, which is sure to be better than the one that comes with this mic. So to conclude, this microphone is a bit difficult to summarize. I've seen it for a bunch of different prices, under a bunch of different names, with a bunch of different accessories, but they all generally seem to at least include a stand and cost around $20. So while it's perfectly acceptable, for the $20, I honestly don't see this mic as being worth it. I would instead recommend the CMTech microphone for $4 more. I'd say, as a whole, this microphone is passable, but I'll probably end up going to it as a last resort. It is much better than a built-in laptop or computer mic, but I feel like even at $20, it has a hard time justifying its price. If you can get it for more than $10 less than the CMTech USB microphone, then I would consider it. But otherwise, I'd say leave this one out of your cart. I'd like to once again directly thank my patrons for supporting me in the content I make, as well as voting for me to review this microphone next. Also over on my Patreon page, you can see behind the scenes photos, general updates, and get early access on new videos. $3 and above patrons get to vote on monthly patron chosen reviews for me to make, just like this one, and top tier patrons get their name on screen near the end of each video. If this interests you at all, there's a link at the top of the description, but otherwise, I'll talk to you again soon.